Hello and welcome to this video review of InstaDoodle. This intro screen was created with InstaDoodle.
Hello and welcome to this review of InstaDoodle. Now, InstaDoodle is web-based software that allows you to create doodle videos. I think it's quite good and I'm going to review it today. Now, I'm in the sales page. If I scroll down and I go to get InstaDoodle right now, you'll see it costs a lot of money. Do not buy it on a monthly basis. Absolutely not. I'll show you how to get it a lot cheaper. So this page allows you to buy it for a one-time fee of $37. So much better. You can try it out, see if you like it, and you're not locked into a subscription. So I'll put the link to this page in my video description. So I've now logged into InstaDoodle. I'm in the dashboard and you can see there are tutorials where it tells you how to do everything, although I'll explain that. Don't worry about that. And we can also upgrade to Pro if we want to. Now, I think Pro costs $67. Pro costs £63.55. So if you want to upgrade to Pro, you can. So I would look at this at about £100 if you want to get the Pro version. So I'm going to firstly create a new project. And we've got some templates. We can have an empty project or we can have templates. Templates are quite good. I'm going to go for this one. And you can see we've got slides down here and it goes all the way up to 10 slides. If I just click on the preview button, this is what happens. We get a preview, obviously, and we can see things like our laptop's drawn out and our text is drawn out. So I'm going to stop that there. I'm going to go back to slide one. And when we click on things, we can interact with them. So this is really about text. So I'm going to go here and I'm going to change the text to software review. I'm going to have it bold and I'm just going to move its position and I'm going to tilt it ever so slightly. Now, what I can also do is I can pick the animation type. Now, obviously, for most things, I'm going to want draw and I can pick the speed. I can use the slider to make it faster or slower. The slowest is half a second. I can change the font, I can change the color and things like that. So if I go to layers, this has the layers and this is quite similar to Doodly. We've got the order that things are drawn in. And if I click on a layer, I can then go and interact with it. So I can change the animation speed, something that I quite like. The last layer on the slide, which it goes from bottom to top, the last layer in the slide, you can set a delay. So this is going to wait for 2 seconds once it's drawn this in before it goes on to the next slide. There are not any transitions between slides. It doesn't do that. We can have different multipliers of drawing speed. What we can do as well is if we upload a voiceover, then that voiceover will play on that slide and we can sync the slide with the voiceover. So this slide currently takes 5 seconds. I'm going to upload the voiceover you saw in the introduction. And now I'm going to click sync with voiceover and let's have a look at this now.
Hello and welcome to this video review of InstaDoodle. This intro screen was created with InstaDoodle.
So the voiceover is about seconds. I wasn't able to hear that because I've got my microphone plugged in, but I am going to put a comment on the video right now of what I think. So with these type of softwares, these explainer softwares, it's a lot to do with text. It's a lot to do with other things, but the assets are really important. So if we go to Doodles, we can search for characters. And again, this is very similar to Doodly. I don't have a huge library of characters because I haven't got the Pro version, but we can see I've been scrolling for some time and I've got quite a lot of characters. There's also a lot of props, so things like speech bubbles, arrows, etc. And both the characters and the props are searchable, so we might want to have a phone for a prop. Let's have a look. And we've got a smartphone, an old phone, a toy phone, a selfie stick. Now you'll notice some of these are Pro, so you can't use them unless you have the Pro upgrade. If I click on filter, there's categories as well. Now what I do like is that I can upload my own images. And if I were to upload my own images, I can have it transformed into a doodle sketch. So if I click here, I can transform it into a doodle sketch. It doesn't always work very well, this. So I've just added one of my video thumbnails. Let's see how good it does.
A few moments later.
So this is it. So it hasn't done a brilliant job, and quite often it doesn't do a brilliant job. So I'm going to delete that. I'm going to do one more just for luck. So this is a picture of an Ace Pro action camera. So again, this hasn't really worked very well. For whatever reason, it hasn't worked very well. So these that I used for one of my videos on the DJI Neo, I actually went to a specialist AI website to do these, and these have come out really well. So these have come from images. In fact, that one hasn't, but these three have come from images, and I had to go to a specialist AI site for that. The other thing that I really like is you can generate your images or your doodles with AI. Let's see how this works. So I actually generated the drone image with AI. So I'm just going to put action camera. Now we get four variations, which is really good. So I'm going to click generate. I think this is such a good feature that you can generate your doodle images here. We've got one, that's not very good. We've got two, that's an awful lot better. So out of four, we've got one that's good, one that's passable, one that's the wrong thing, and one that, oh, I'm not even going to go there. So I'm going to add this to the library. Okay, so that's added to the library, and then I can just click and I can have it come in, and I can obviously resize it, etc. If I click on these three dots, I can then change the positioning, bring it backwards or forwards, flip it horizontal or vertical, or duplicate it, which is really useful. So once we've made our video, all we have to do is click export. Again, if you want to export at a higher resolution, you need the pro upgrade, but you first click render, and then once it's rendered, you get an email to tell you it's rendered, and then you just click to download. You use the same export functionality. I actually think this is really good for $37, and who knows, I may even upgrade to pro. So if you have any questions, please leave a comment and I will get straight back to you.